Hey boy, the other morning, a couple days ago, I had some ground meat left over from a cook that I did that I probably ain't even gonna bother to post, because it was just too easy. So I made me a hamburger, and I modified my grill. I've already showed y'all that, to where the burner itself had rusted out, and I put a gas log in there that makes flames. I don't know if y'all remember Burger King, before they converted to their new broiling technique, which is infrared, used to put the burgers on like a conveyor belt kind of thing, or a treadmill, and it was open exposed grates, and the burgers would travel over these little flames, flame broiled burger. Well, how come any, and they use natural gas for it. Well, how come any burger cooked over an open flame, like on a propane pit, don't taste the same? The gas, it doesn't matter what kind of gas you're burning, just open flame, number one. Now, a burger cooked over charcoal or real wood tastes way better, period. You ain't never heard nobody say, "Oh, I love the taste of a gas-cooked burger." Bullshit, if you said you do. So I got some more of that meat. It's left over. I ain't gonna eat it. I'm gonna make some burgers for the dog just to reenact this for you. I already know the outcome of this. Alright, when you're making your burgers, don't try to get seasoning inside the meat, because you're gonna end up with what's gonna look like a piece of sausage. But do make an indention in the middle. That way when they shrink up, they won't be like that. They'll be more uniform. They won't be like that, they'll be more uniform. So make an indention in every burger. You only gotta do it on one side. And just season the outside of the meat. So, like I said, this is for my dogs. I ain't gonna eat this. Meat's too old for me. A little pepper on it, and that's it. You wanna put onion powder, Worcestershire, whatever you want, put it on there. Just don't mix it into the meat inside, because then your meat's gonna come out like a piece of sausage. It's gonna be tougher and chewier. So you don't wanna handle the meat too much. You see how it's kind of breaking off on the edges? Just tuck it in a little bit without trying to work the shit out of it. Now let's go outside on the modified grill, and I'm gonna show y'all what I'm talking about here. Okay, so there's the gas fireplace log that replaced my rusted out burner. Oh, look, see, it just fall apart. Normally, you got a heat diffuser called a vaporizer bar that sits over the burner underneath the grate, though, boy. Let me give this thing a little bit of air. I see it's smoking too much. There we go. Now we got some air. You can also move this thing around. And that's what I did with the other morning for that burger that I made to simulate the flame broil and try to give it that taste. So, we're going to go ahead and slap these burgers right over that flame, just like that. Like I said, this is for my dogs. They're going to be some happy dogs, too. Just like Burger King's flame broil burger. But they don't come out tasting like a Burger King burger. What's up with that? I can tell you what's up with it. They putting a damn flavoring on their burger. A flame broil taste. I see McCormick sells a flame broiled seasoning. Now, yeah, you can get them nice and charred, see? Ain't no problem with that. You can even put your vaporizer bar back in place. This thing over here. I welded a washer on there where I can put a piece of wood on it to give it more hickory flavor too. But the real way to cook, can't go wrong with charcoal briquettes. Now let's see how they coming. Flame kissed, you see? Yeah, look at that. A flame broiled burger. That was a little too well done. Dog's angle, bad or no? That one looks nice. So does that one. Flame kissed. Flame broiled burger. You might want to turn that fire down a little bit there, JB. Oh, the other way. But it don't taste nothing like Burger King's burger. That's my point. I had one the other morning. Tastes like a burger that's cooked over gas. Cool, huh? So they using a flame broil seasoning on their burger at Burger King. Well, I'm sure it ain't McCormick brand. I'm sure they got something that's specially made just for them. And go figure. Cook over real wood or goddamn charcoal. Don't use that freaking propane grill to cook with. The only thing I use this for is to light my damn charcoals with. I fill up a chimney with charcoal and set it right on top of that gas jet. Go, boy, go, cook. You wanna eat? You gotta make a fire. Now here's another tip. Never, ever mash down on your burgers. Never do that. What you're doing is you're mashing all the good juice out of them. You have a dry burger if you do that. So never smash down on it. See all that grease coming out of it when I do that? You don't want to do that, man. What you think this is, Whataburger or McDonald's? To recap, make an indention in your burger so they come out more uniform in size. Salt and pepper it. Don't try to mix seasonings inside of it. And try to cook them over charcoal or wood fire. Don't. If you're going to use gas, natural gas, now this is convenient to cook over a gas grill because it's quick. Bam, light. Go. That is non-union, but they are convenient. So, if you want a flame broil whopper from Burger King, you better go over there and go find a seasoning that they're using. Google flame broil seasoning. You'll see they got a bunch of different brands out there. And that's what Burger King is using, either their own proprietary mix or somebody else's. So there you have it, folks. Flame broil dog food. Yeah. And I ain't eating that. The dog's gonna love it. They back over there. Just watching, waiting. They know it's theirs.